Let us cross to Adelaide to Sky News South Australian correspondent Joel Philp to make sense of this election. Joel Philp, look, I've been really liking your reports in the last couple of weeks about all this. And you were just at the Sky News People Forum, the debate between Marshall and Malinouskas. How did that go? Did it help to explain why the polls show the Liberal government is going to be kicked out after just one term?
Well, Andrew, I think it's first worth pointing out that you're actually probably right when we say that it's not so much about what the Premier has done wrong recently is as much as what the opposition leader, Peter Malinouskas, has done right. Over the past year or so, while we've had Stephen Marshall indeed working hand in hand with Nicola Spurrier and Grant Stevens announcing, the COVID measures every day, Peter Malinouskas has been in the background meeting with hospitality industry, meeting with ambulance workers, and they are really rallying to his cause now. This has been something that has been bubbling up in the background, has really come to the forefront during the election campaign in which Peter Malinouskas is finally able to get more airtime. And it was really on show tonight. Once again, we saw Peter Malinouskas, a seasoned political politician who was able to, remain quite calm, but then bring up the energy without getting frazzled when hammering home that point about health. In the meantime, Stephen Marshall was fairly calm and confident, but he never really picked up that extreme energy that you might think a political leader might have if he was behind in the poll. So what we saw was a result tonight of 67% to the Labor Party, 22% to the Liberals, and 11% of the people who were here were undecided. It's worth noting that at the last press club debate, many people said that the Premier, Stephen Marshall, actually won it, that he had a kind of a wit there. He was fairly quick at thinking on his feet, and it worked well with that audience, but he didn't bring that same wit to tonight's debate with a very different audience of, you might say, average voters who really wanted specific issues addressed that impacted their lives.